Joined in the news at 10 by a professor of international law in the University of Lagos, Akin Oyebode. Thank you so much for joining us on the news at 10.
You're welcome.
Now, this is one issue that has many people divided into two major camps, those that are for and those against. So where do you stand on this decision?
I'm definitely against condoning nefarious practices like corruption, petty thievery. We have to distinguish political offenses from common theft. So if somebody finds his fingers in the till and we catch him red-handed, public till that is, such a person is undeserving of any pardon. He's a felon, at best an ex-con. And people say, show me your friends and I'll tell you the person you are. It seems as if the tolerance level of President Jonathan and his confederates is so high for corrupt practices. And in fact, I think it's a desecration of our national values. The traditional society has always frowned against untoward conduct. So I find the pardon granted to people accused of stealing from the public purse as most gratuitously undeserving.
Well, it's interesting that you should say that, because I interviewed a former Attorney General of the Federation, Chief Richard Akinjide, and he was quite pleased with the decision. And let me just read to you what he said. He said the members of the Council of State include former heads of state, attorneys general, and past presidents. These are people with wisdom who consider the parameters carefully, so critics should be mindful. How do you react to that?
I don't understand what he's saying. This is a democracy. It's not a gerontocracy. The Council of State is merely advisory. And from what I've been reading in the press, it seems they were ambushed by President Jonathan. They were not put in the total picture. I have nothing against granting amnesty, as I said, to political offenders, those who have been convicted for treason. It might, for me, be a little bit gratuitous to be granting pardon to those who are no longer with us. It's almost as asinine as giving honorary degrees to the dead. But in terms of public perception of corrupt practices, it's a very terrible signal that we seem to be comfortable with corrupt people.
I was going to also go into that, the signal you're talking about, to the international community, because Nigeria is party to the African Convention Against Corruption. Now, you're a professor of international law. How does this make us look?
Well, Nigeria's reputation internationally has been below zero, quite sincerely. The picture of the ugly Nigerian is pervasive throughout the international community. But what I find most galling about this effort is that Nigeria is cast itself in the mold of an international outlaw. We are signatory not just to the African Anti-Corruption Convention, but also the UN Anti-Corruption Convention. In international law, we have a maxim, pacta sunt servanda. Treaties must be implemented. But Nigeria is saying that it's thumbing its nose at its international obligations. That is going to be bad news in terms of a country that is seeking foreign direct investment, that wants importation of practically everything that we need or use from foreign suppliers. I know corruption is a universal problem. You find it in practically everywhere, in China, in India, United States, UK, Germany, and what have you. But what I find extremely discomforting is the fact that those who have been alleged to be partaking in corrupt practices in foreign countries have been left off the hook. In fact, we are almost verging towards awarding them national honors.
But from a legal perspective, those who are supporting it have cited history, looking at the likes of Chief Odumegwu, Ojukwu, Awolowo and co, you know, having received pardon. And when we look at others like Adisa and Dia, from a legal perspective, is it better to grant pardon to someone who has plotted a coup or someone who has been corrupt?
Well, as I said, in terms of political misdemeanors, pardons are well taken. I remember as a student, President Ford granted pardon to Richard Nixon. And that was why somebody like Gil Scott-Heron, the famous rapper, came out with an album, "I Beg Your Pardon, Mr. President." So quite sincerely, it's a pity people like Fela are no longer with us, who will have said this is a PDP stealing. You know, he spoke about authority stealing. it seems the PDP is very comfortable with corruption, because in this country we have people who are accused of accomplices in corrupt practices in Europe, but what did we find them here doing? They either presided over the party or became ministers in this country. And you remember the president himself did not give a damn about declaring his public assets. So when you have people who now say they don't give a damn about international law...
I might have to ask you, Prof, to watch your tone there.
No. I'm an international lawyer. I'm a professor of international law. You ask me a direct question.
Yes.
We are thumbing our noses at our international obligations. The next thing we should do is actually to send bills to the National Assembly to repeal the EFCC Act or the ICPC Act, or even amend the Constitution of Nigeria so that the Code of Conduct provisions should be expunged. Because really, it couldn't be worse. This is a very sad day for the country.
All right. I'm going to thank you so much for your perspective. Very strong words there indeed, Professor Akin Oyebode. Thank you so much for joining us.